Get off me, you tiny little...
Well, there should be a nerve cluster in here somewhere.
Ah! Ah! Ah!
I told you to stay out of my way.
Wonder what would happen if I did this.
I hate this planet.
Only one way to beat the desert heat, don't you think? Triggering the correct sequence of synapses should allow me some rudimentary motor control. There appears to be a mountain peak 13.2 miles due west
with a vertical angle of 45 degrees.
Brainiac, how about a street?
Oh yeah, it's Ripley. What's your malfunction? Probably something stupid like the DNA splicing replicator copying a fragmented amino acid sequence. So this is what it feels like to be smart. Gwen, grab that pulse hypercore. Grandpa, the galenium capacitor. It's not Ben talking, it's gray matter. Do it! If I can get inside the power grid, I can hook the hypercore and capacitor up to it. This is where small comes in handy.
Shock collars. They're disabled.
All it takes is a short circuit and a little gray matter.
Good job, Ben.
Recalibrate the freon evaporation cycle, expand the expansion valves, and realign these condenser coils. The amplification of current suggests a fission of unstable and undeterminable isotopes. Shutting down power source now! Is what I call a sweet landing. Guess how many jelly beans and win a music pocket? Way too easy for the little guy with the mega brain. The average size of a jelly bean is 1.3 centimeters. We're talking 6,532. 31 jelly beans. I figured out what old Bolthead is up to. He's going to project a corrodium beam from the space station to a transceiver in New Mexico.
Which will then spread it over the entire Earth.
New Mexico? Like where we first took on the werewolf?
Duh! That's why he was stealing that satellite equipment.
A beam of corrodium like that will mutate all human and animal life on Earth.
I think that's just a side effect. With the sun blocked out, Ghost Freak would be at full power all the time.
Ghost Freak?